SUVs aren't really designed for extreme off-roading, but if you should find yourself off-road or you want to go off-road, it's really important to know what your car can do and how you use it. Let's have a look.
Now, before you go off-road, there's a few things you need to think about. First of all is the weather conditions and the tyres that you've got and the kind of area that you're going to go into. Is it really remote? Is it not? You might want to let people know that you're going out, especially if you're going by yourself. Okay, so we're going to engage all-wheel drive lock before we head off. We're going to engage our downhill brake assist, our downhill brake control, engage first gear manual. We're not going to be going very quick on this off-road course, so we drive as slow as possible and as fast as necessary. We move across into first gear. Handbrake off, and we're heading off onto the course. And as I come up to this, the brow of this crest, I can see that the road is dropping away from me. I don't know what's beyond there, and had I not driven this course before, I would be actually walking it on foot to double check what we've got. As we come in here, we can feel the car shifting on the road, and in actual fact, what happens is we drop into a hole there and it lifts the rear wheel by about a meter, and that's called a cross-axle event. Again, driving across here, going through some elephant footprints, so just gently letting the car roll through them, always remembering that what the front of the car goes through, the back of the car has to go through as well. I'm now coming onto a side slope. Now, generally speaking, we say avoid side slopes at all costs unless you absolutely have to. And if you haven't driven it before, you definitely want to check it. We're on 25 degrees of side slope at the moment, and I'm driving along very slowly. You have to be aware of what's on the top and what's on the bottom. Stones on the top may lift the car over its side slope capability. Holes on the bottom could do the same thing. And at this point, we're transitioning into another cross-axle event. So I'm just applying the throttle very gently to get the brake traction control to pull us through. And then we're up onto a 30 degree side slope. So now you can see we're at even more of an angle, and the greater the angle you go at, the more careful you have to be, especially thinking about how the vehicle is loaded. You want to keep a low center of gravity, and you want to ensure that things like your tire pressures are all correct. You would do that anyway at the beginning of your off-road trip, ideally. And you want to make sure that your load is secure within the car, because on a side slope, a load that is unsecure and slides to one side or the bottom side of the car, then that could be enough to actually tip the vehicle over. So our next obstacle on the course is a 27 degree ascent or climb, and that then goes into a 30 degree descent. Now, rule of thumb for climbing hills off-road is always go up a slope and down a slope the way that water would go down the slope. I know where I'm going at the top, so I'm going to drive up and stop when we get onto the horizontal level at the top. So enough power to keep me moving up the slope without wheels spinning, and at the top I stop. And at this point, I'm just going to come completely off the brake and allow the vehicle to move forward and the downhill brake control function to engage and bring me slow the speed of descent down. So here we go, off the brake, watching where I'm going, and very quickly that we hit 7 kilometers an hour and the braking effect comes into play, and that brings us nice and smoothly down to the bottom of the slope. The Hyundai Tucson opens up new opportunities for you as a driver. You've got a great four-wheel drive system here which can work automatically, or you can engage it when you want to. And this gives you the ability to go into areas that you wouldn't be able to go into with an ordinary road car, thereby being able to discover fantastic areas of your own country, of your own countryside, or other places in the world.
SUVs are capable of a lot more than some people think. However, they're not designed primarily for off-road use. So if you want to take them off-road, be sure and check the track and make sure you're careful how you use the car, and you'll still have a lot of fun.